energy. Can we put your hands together for Mr. Paul Dunn?
Can I hire you for everywhere I go? That was awesome. Give yourselves a big round of applause. Yourself. Whoa. That was just absolutely stunning. Thank you. I've never had a welcome like that before in my life. This must be like an awesome group of people pushing humanity forward or something. Is that the general idea? So I am absolutely thrilled that just out of perchance, you know, I arrive in Bali for ILAB and you guys arrive in Bali for Awesomeness Fest, and bang, we connect. How special is that, huh? That's just really, really cool. And John said to me, you know, Paul, you've done 3 TED Talks, and so can you do another TED Talk? And I thought, well, that's kind of challenging because, as you know, where's Pascal? As Pascal knows, because he's done one, right, in French. What they do at TED, they give you what's called the TED Commandments, and you have 18 minutes to give the speech of your life. And I never thought that I would get an invitation to do TED. The reason is, as you're kind of finding out right now, it usually takes me 25 minutes to say hello. So, you know, to do. Anyway, let's do this. I want you to imagine, if you would, that it's not 2013, okay? So let's just go back in time. We're actually going to go back about 337 years to 1676. And I want you to imagine that you didn't come to Bali for Awesomeness Fest. What you actually did, you turned up in London. And the reason you went to London was for a meeting of the Royal Society. And the reason you wanted to go to that meeting of the Royal Society was you were going to hear what it was like to have this guy, or you're going to meet with this guy who had an apple fall on his head. And he was about to sort of expose what that was all about. So yes, that's the guy we're going to meet, as in Sir Isaac Newton, right? And what's so interesting about Sir Isaac is when he began that speech on the 25th of February, 1676, take a look at what he said. He said this. He said, if I have seen a little further, it's by standing on the shoulders of giants. And I thought, how true is that in Awesomeness Fest and all the kind of wonderful things that you do? Is that kind of hit it? Yeah, it does. And then I thought, well, what we should do is see how some of those giants are. Well, here's one that you know, right? And John said some really nice things about me, but how would it be to have a tag that's, you know, all about pushing humanity forward? And you know, until yesterday, I didn't realize that we were on that same path. So this is another reason why this is very, very special. And then someone else who does the same thing, another giant, actually 2 giants, one of them you know, this guy over here, this is Roger Hamilton in pirate uniform. It is. Who saw Roger yesterday? Or was it yesterday or the day before, right? And I know you got so much from Roger. And here he is hanging out on Necker Island with this guy, Mr. Branson, both of whom we are going to meet as we go through our time together. You okay for that? Say yes, because then we'll finish close to time. Okay. And we're also going to meet this guy. Now, some of you know this guy. If you don't, you should. Okay. So his name is Seth Godin. And I don't know anybody who so expresses so accurately the times that we are in. You really do need to sign up for Seth's blog. Take a look at what he said recently. In fact, too many words on there, so let me shorten it down. He says now, because times have changed. Is that fair? Times have changed, and they continue to change at a staggering pace. And he says we are now in the connection economy, not the experience economy, but the connection economy. Take a look at the resources. The resources are who trusts you, who wants to hear from you, who will collaborate, support, and engage with you. Now, here is the world's number one marketing consultant, and he's saying what's important is not some tricky marketing stuff, right? He's saying this is what's important. In fact, let me blow that up a little bit more for you. He says this, is my next action, kind of interesting thing to put on our mirrors, is our next action going to build a relationship or take from it? Am I earning trust or burning trust? You like that one? How many like that one? It's really cool, huh? But it gets even better. You ready for more? Have a look at this. Seth gives us, he gives us 9 things. Now, I know there are only 3 there, 6 there, but I'm going to give you another 3 as we go through. He says, these are some of the things that are really important. Trust always was important, but now more so than ever in this particular economy post-2008. This one, remarkability. How many of us own our own businesses? Can I just see that one? Good. How many of us don't own our businesses but work for someone who does? Like, you know, and anybody own our own businesses and wish to hell we did not? Any of them? Okay. And so we all have competitors, if you will, and yes, we should be collaborating, but the key question is, how do we stand out? How do we be remarkable? and how do we get through great leadership stuff. And of course, as you know from Awesomeness Fest, it's all about stories that spread. But get a look at this. Get a look at this. This is the world's number one marketing guru. Nowhere in any MBA course being spoken about on this planet today will you hear anybody say it's actually about that. And years ago, we would not see that stuff. Though I don't know about you, that's why I'm excited to be living at this particular time. And by the way, he spreads this out even more. Here's the other three. He says it's about connection, it's about compassion, and it's about humility. I'm sure all of the stuff that you've been hearing about over the last few days or so. Let's see if we can step that up a little higher, though, by looking at these two: trust, humanity, and connection. I don't know about you, but who knows Stephen Covey? You all know Stephen Covey? Not the Stephen Covey who died recently, but his son who wrote Speed of Trust. And on September the 10th, I'm speaking in London with Stephen Covey, and it's called the Trust Conference. And as I was thinking about that Trust Conference, how would you express trust? And I said, well, humanity, trust equals connection. Trust equals connection. So if you look at all of the stuff that's happening in our world, if you look at all of the stuff that's happening in the Middle East, if you look at all of that stuff, guess where it comes from? It comes from a lack of trust, which comes from a lack of connection, right? So this is where we really, really, really need to be heading. And this person, if you watch Ted, how many of us know Ted like the back of our hand, okay? So you would know Brené. Brené and I know each other, and you've probably seen that talk, which has, you know, almost as many views as Science X talk. It has 11 million, I think, as of this morning or so, yes. And I love what she said. There's so much that she said in that vulnerability talk, but I love this piece. Connection is why we're here. Do you get that? Take a minute to get that. Connection is why we're here. Why we're here. Why we're here. Why we're here. Okay? So just to prove that, what I want you to do, I didn't think I would do this, but are you okay if we do something that you're not supposed to do in a TED talk? You okay with that? Okay, here's what I want you to do. I want you to just eyeball someone right next to you. Go ahead, just look them in the eye, just smile at them. Go ahead, look them in the eye and smile at them. And then as you're smiling at them, give them, when I say go, give them a big high five and say to them, I am thrilled to be connected with you. Go for it. I am thrilled to be connected with you. Awesome, awesome. Awesome, awesome, awesome. So let's see where that goes then. Connection then is all about what I think it's about is the power of small. It's not about big things. It's about little tiny things. It's about whether, for example, you know, we have a meeting and you tell me you're going to get there at 2 o'clock, but you don't get there at 2 o'clock. All of a sudden, you break my trust. Do you get that? It's all about small. And so let's just take a look at some of the small things. Now, some of you may have flown through this place. Did any of you fly through this place? If you did, the guys in particular are going to get some sort of flashbacks here. So here's Changi Terminal 3, the most award-winning airport in the world. 357 awards that thing has got. And the Singapore government spent $1.8 billion, that's a lot of money, even in Singapore dollars. This is not Indonesian rupiah or something, right? So but come with me. This was the soft opening. Oh, there's the awards. This was the soft opening of the thing. And I'm there with my camera and everything else. And I don't know whether this is an age thing. By the way, I do have a microphone on here. This is actually a heart starter thing as well. So for my age. So anyway, so if it dies, we're in trouble. You know what I'm saying? So anyway, yes. So here I am on the soft opening and I'm taking pictures of it. And all of a sudden, and I think maybe this is an age thing, but all of a sudden I just desperately wanted to go to the, this is very personal. Or desperately wanted to go to the toilet. It's an age thing, right? So this gives me the opportunity to look around and check out the signage because I really need to go, you see? So I look around, 180, oh! And I look at that and I go, oh, one of them is me, which is really cool. Okay. So I go, now the planners at Singapore Airport know that men, guys, you're going to hate me for this, but men are directionally challenged. Now, we are, guys. The women know that because you go to a drawer in your bedroom which has, like, things in it, and you say, where'd you put my socks? They're in the drawer. Anyway, so what they do is they put arrows in the tiles to make sure that we guys don't lose our way. Watch. Here it is. So I'm following, seriously, So I'm following these arrows going, oh God, I hope I get there soon, kind of thing, right? And have a look what I land on. Have a look. Now just express whatever you want to express when you see where I end up. Here it is. Oh my God, right? The first thing that came up for me is, I'm in the wrong place. We don't have these things in our stuff. You know what I'm saying, Pascal? We don't, right? But the good thing about guys is guys have very good peripheral vision, see? So I go, oh my God, I'm in the right place. Thank goodness, right? So then I go, oh, let me tell you something about guys. They won't want to tell you this, but I'll tell you anyway. Ladies, all the guys in the room will go to this one. They will. And the reason we go to that one is because we think that if you can only see half of us, we're invisible. That's what we think, okay? So I go to this one. Now remember, without getting too personal, I am bursting to go, right? Remember that. So I go to this one, and then all of a sudden I go, oh my God, I cannot possibly go. Now notice how pristine and clean this place is, with one exception. Now, the ladies have already seen the problem, right? Because they see detail, but the guys haven't. So guys, follow the red dot. Here we go. Oh my God, there's a fly. There's a fly in the toilet. So I go, and I get to the next one, and there's a fly in that one. And then I get to the next one. Now at this point, you are probably thinking Paul has an IQ of 3 on a good day, right? So, because it's at this moment when I'm in this one that I get close. I mean, it's embarrassing. I'm on my hands and knees looking at this thing. And there's the fly, and it's at this moment, I don't touch it, by the way, but it's at this moment that I realize this is not a fly. This is a design of a fly that is etched into the vitreous enamel. This, ladies and gentlemen, is an aiming device. That's what this is, right? And by the way, you can check. It's amazing. The power of small, it's amazing. There are studies online where they say things like, we have reduced the amount of spillage. Seriously. They do. And many of the ladies, you know, if you want one of these, we do sell them here at Vision Villa, so you can get them. But what's the point? The point is this. When you fly out of Bali and maybe you hit Singapore, have a guess where you'll go. Now, remember, what was the price of the airport again? $1.8 billion. But where you'll go is you'll go and you'll look for that fly, particularly if you're a guy. And if you're a lady, you'll go up to someone and accost them and say, would you mind going into the gents, please? Because there's something interesting. So does everybody get it? It's all about small. And it's all about small to the extent that it's those little things. And you know this in everything that you do. It is the small things that make the profound difference. It really is only the small things, not those big things. So let's work on that. And by the way, it's also sometimes it's slightly bigger. Roger was talking about sometimes it's outside of ourselves as well as inside. So what about environment? The environment that we create, is that sort of part of it? Well, come with me to Zurich. And let's go to this place. Let's go to the Googleplex in Zurich and take a look. This is how you go from floor to floor. Now, there are some people who kind of overthink things and they'll say, wow, that's really cool, but how do you get back up again? Don't worry about how you get back up again. How many people think this is cool? It's really, really cool. And if you're really in a hurry, bang, then you can go down there. And then if you want to go to one of the offices, for example, and they change this every season, but if you happen to be there when it's cold, which it usually is in Zurich, of course, then that's the offices right there, right? And this is not a real penguin, for those of you who are concerned with life. How many people look at that and you go, wow, if I was in that environment, I think I would be so much more creative. Can I just see your hands if you think that, right? So the environment that we create is very, very interesting. What's that word, nice and loud? Wow. Oh, that was the loudest I've ever heard. Okay, let me show you how even people like accountants do this. This is an accounting firm. It's in Cheltenham in the United Kingdom. Do we have anyone here from the United Kingdom? Am I talking too fast or are you? Okay, no, you're okay, very good. And your first name is?
Nikki.
Correct. So, Nikki, so just for the moment, think about accounting firms. You would not associate accounting firms with pushing humanity forward. You would not. You would absolutely not associate accounting firms with being able to answer this question. Why do you get up every morning? You would absolutely not, they would say, oh, to do the numbers, right? But take a look at this. Tyabali Tomlin, changing lives around the world. How cool is that? And it's an accounting firm. And then take a look over here. This is what I do, of course, B1G1 or buy one, give one. But take a look here. Tyabali Tomlin, you, boom, a better world. This, I say again, is an accounting firm. But take a look at this, right? Giving. This is right up front on their website. How many of us know my friend Simon, as in Simon Sinek? Anybody, you've watched the video. If you haven't watched Simon's video, just go watch Simon's video. And it's all about why we do stuff. It's not what we do, it's why we do it. And take a look at this. You can read most of it. I won't blow it up too much. But look, giving. We believe in an inclusive society. For us, helping our clients succeed and succeeding ourselves brings with it a social responsibility. I remind you again, this is an accounting firm. I remind you of that. A duty towards those who may be less fortunate, because look at this line, because I invented this line, because businesses should have the power to change everyone's lives. In fact, that's not true. Businesses have the power to change everyone's lives. It's just a question of whether we will grab it. That's really the question. And whether we will not do it as something that's kind of off the side, but whether we embed it as part of how we live. That's the real question. And these guys do. See that? That's why we've embedded giving into everything we do. Let's take a look at another part of this. Look at this. This is how it works. Let me blow this up for you. Why on earth would they have a goat right there on an accountant's site? You decide to work with us, allowing us to change your life and your business for the better. Together you choose whether Tyabali Tomlin will give a Kenyan or a goat or a sheep to a family in Kenya, which will give that family in Kenya a sustainable income for the rest of their lives. Well, actually, probably for the rest of the goat's life, but you know what I'm saying. Okay. But actually, as a result of this, they have now set up the largest sustainable goat farm in the whole of Africa. It's stunning. And you see 200 women who can barely speak English doing breeding programs on spreadsheets in the hot sun. It is the most amazing thing. And that's led to hospitals and all sorts of things, just from these things. Or the gift of sight. And then look at this. Throughout the year, we carry out our agreed work with you for every chargeable, well, you can read this. For every chargeable service we provide, we undertake to match a portion of our fee and channel it to a range of projects around the world. These include, take a look at this, gift of sight, medical support, hygiene, sanitation. This is not, we proudly support the Red Cross. That's not what this is about. This is about making an impact. It's not about the money that they give. It's absolutely not. It's about the impact that they make. And you'll see more about that in just a second. You can see it. And then every time you hopefully learn something and you hopefully get something from us too. And then finally, this last little piece on these guys anyway, you can see giving again. And let's just go down here. What we're looking at here is their why. And unless, and we've been working on that at ILAB this morning. Unless, we said to the guys this morning, guys, unless and until you've got your why, unless you're really clear about why you get up every morning, then it doesn't matter how many particular skills we give you, unless you're clear on that why, it's not going to happen. What's that word again?
Wow.
Very, very good. Quickly, final little piece, and then I want to show you a film. It says, is a toothpick small enough to make a difference? Well, let's imagine that down the road here, maybe over lunch, you could get a coffee. That's a cappuccino, and maybe it would look like that. But let me take you to a place where it looks a little different. If you'd like a cappuccino, you can have it like this. If you like it like this, you can have it like this. If you don't like that one, you can get that one. If you don't like that one, you can get that one. That's this one. Next one is my favorite one. Isn't that just the coolest thing? Now, without me even saying anything, if this was a few hundred meters or 100 yards away, how many of us would go there? Can I just see your hands? Look at that. Look at that. It's right out there because they've broken through this speed barrier that we really need to break through. And by the way, they even have one for the Christian community as well. So it's kind of cool. But let's just go there. Just go there. Look at this. I just want you to see the power of small and just how the words that you use can make such a difference. Look at this. That is it. It's actually in Brisbane. In a bit. It doesn't just say coffee shop. It says inspirational coffee. Do you get that? By the way, what sort of people do they hire? Only people who are? Inspiring, exactly. They have an inspirational menu. Take a look at this. There it is. One of the words that we talk about at ILAB, one of the things we get people to realize, is that words matter. Words matter. But how about this? This is about 10 pages up in the menu. So in other words, you flip through the menu, you've got connected to the menu, and then you see delicious mains. But look at this thing down here. Let me blow that up for you, which, by the way, I've learned never to say in Los Angeles. There you go, delicious mains. But let me just look at this thing right here. And a critical, critical, important thing. And everybody who's pushing humanity forward understands this, right? Purpose matters. Purpose matters. It's not what you do, it's what you believe in. Purpose matters. And so imagine when you go to that coffee shop, and all of us would go based on what you told me. Then imagine if every time you purchased a coffee, it's hard for me to read this, that 100 people had access to clean water for a day. Just imagine that. Imagine if every time you dined with us, you provided health support for a child for a month. And it goes on and on. Now, let me ask you this question. Show me your hands again, those of us who would go. Can I see your hands on that? Okay. How many of us would go back? Right. How many of us would tell our friends? And so clearly what happens is this business rockets. Do you get that? It rockets. But this is probably the most important thing that I'm going to share with you today. By the way, thank you for being so attentive. Sure, their business grows, but that's not the reason why Bruce, the owner of this place, does that. The reason Bruce does that is that's because that's who Bruce is. Do you see that? There's no, I'll do this and then we'll do that. Do you see that? It's just who he is. And so a way of expressing that is it's about connection. And the most important connection for Bruce, of course, is the connection to himself. And unless and until we have that connection, then we can't get the connection to our teams, and then we can't get the connection to our customers. Does that make sense? Say yes, because then we'll finish really soon. Yes. And of course, what happens is the business rockets. But again, that's not the point. It's just who Bruce is. So we mentioned this guy earlier on when he was with Roger. Very few people have seen this. It goes for about 47 seconds. So have a listen to what Mr. Branson has to say about what you and I have been saying.
I think that in the past, business people were apt to think, you know, the politicians will look after, the medical side, the social issues of this world, and business will make the money, pay their taxes, and then the politicians will take it and spend it. I think the problem with that is that, the politicians maybe don't have the experience that entrepreneurs have to really go out there and make a difference in the world, and that it's much better that politicians and business leaders work together, and the social sector work together. So I think that if every single business can find their niche in the world where they want to make a difference, then I think we can get on top of most of the problems of the world.
And had he known about you, he would have said, this is how we push humanity forward. Do you get that? But the interesting question is, I mean, he just said some interesting things, but what if that was actually possible for every business to do that? What if it was? What if it was actually possible for every single business, including yours, to change lives? What if it was? And what if it was actually possible to do that just by doing what you normally do? Now, some people in the front here just got something, right? And it says, please, can I just sort of hold it up for a second? It says, no peeking, okay? Now is the time to peek. Just go ahead. Now, I know the guys at the back didn't get this, but I'll show you what they're peeking at whilst you peek on it. Can someone read what it says? Just go ahead.
Certificate of gratitude. By being at this event with us, you have automatically given 17 children access to life-saving water for a day. We hope, too, that your own life is richer in every sense by being with us today. At B1G1, we believe that every business has the power to change lives by integrating giving into its everyday business activities. We hope you'll join us in making more of that happen. Thank you for making a difference just by being here.
Wow. That's pretty cool. And that's true for every single person, 17 kids. For every single person, for you, every single person, 17 kids will get access to water as a result of you being here. So you guys made a real difference. Go on, applaud yourselves. You really... Now, final point. So you're getting where we're going with this, that it's about embedding stuff, it's about pushing humanity forward, it's about doing different things as a part of what we normally do. You know, I met this interesting lady in 2007 who actually was at this very place. And she said, her name is Masami, a Japanese lady, and she had one of those sort of breakthrough things that you have, and she had a business, and what she said was, I realized that if I let go of my business, I can create something even bigger. And the answer to that question of what was this, I can create, she said, a world that's full of giving. And then she said, because that's a happier world, which we all get, right? And then, at that moment, pretty much at that moment, she created this.
Give One, a simple idea, sharing the joy of giving, every second, every day, in every way.
I caught up with that. What do you think? Is that a cool thing? Never doubt that simple little idea that you have, whatever that idea is, whether you got it from these last 3 or 4 days, or in whatever it is you do, maybe even over lunch. Right? Never doubt that idea can create amazing things. Let me show you what I mean by that. This is the B1G1 website. Let me just blow up something here now. So take a look at this. From that simple idea, 30 million giving impacts being created worldwide as a result of all of the businesses that are part of this. What do you reckon? Is that awesome or? And if you want to find out more about that, then you know, come by and see us, and we'll tell you how you become a part of that. Final 2 points. This is from Seth Godin. He said this: the challenge. By the way, have you enjoyed this as much as I have? Okay. Seth said this: the challenge and the opportunity is simple. It's not how to figure out how to be successful. It's how do we figure out how to matter. That's the crucial piece. And then this. And the way we matter is connecting people to a story. A story that resonates, a story that people care about, and a story that they'll tell other people. Keep on telling your story. Thank you. Thank you very much.